Cross that at the bio. Mais mon peu quand tu m'arrives par une prochaine maintenant le monde on met des cas qui ne mouche le gauche le bien le riche riche à tout ce qu'on croit avoir ni bouillon fa George so later parce qu'on doit arriver par so au coup des cinq cocon on c'est un meilleur signe donc c'est quoi le cocon. I'm not going to be able to do it. Àwọn mẹ́rin èmi náà ni mò ń dápọ́ kó tó di pé sickness yìí dé àtúndé sí ìwọ pọ́n mo ṣe ní káwọn ọmọ nàìjíríà àwọn mi lọ́wọ́ kọ́ má jẹ kú báyìí ó yẹ kí n jẹ àwọn ọmọ mi kọ́ má yẹ kí wà lámì já sásán o. Kin le lo fi treat gbogbo yan mi no ti degbo ati oso for treatment mo se ni ko Nigeria ko jo ko shanu mi ko assist mi awon mo ko awon lo wa lohun mi mi re bi oko mi re yan emi ni kon na ni amo pa mo ti sick mi le jade sise mi ni okun mo se lati jade lo sise. Kò sí nǹkan kan ti jẹun gan àwọn ọmọ ń dáwó fún mi ni a fi feed àwọn ọmọ mi nǹkan tí n bá rí mò ń jẹ àwọn ká gbogbo àwọn nǹkan kan sílẹ̀ gan tán ní kí n má jẹ kí nígbà tí ó dẹ sí nǹkan kan ṣá má lè jẹ mò ń jẹ òjò kọ́ ràn mí lọ́wọ́ o kó má jẹun kú báyìí o bí breast cancer yẹn náà ni bí pé kó máa bí kò máa fà mí kò máa ṣàdùn mí ṣe gbogbo ẹ òun ló àfẹ́tì mi lọ́wọ́ mi.
Kò dẹ̀ ń ṣe gbogbo ìgbà ló máa ń sùn.
Ǹjẹ́ ń lè sùn? Ọ̀chì ìgbà mi tọwọ́ yẹn bá ń ta mí tó ń ro mí mi ń lè sùn. Ìgbà kan àwọn ọmọ mi máa ń gbé mi ni máa gbé mi mi ń lè dá dìde ẹ̀rí pé ìgbà táwọn onílẹ̀kùn ọmọ mi ni òun ló wá fà mí.
It actually started early last year. So at first it was something small, like we thought it was something we could handle. So we got our drugs, did a lot of things, and then it actually reduced. But all of a sudden she just started feeling pains in her breast. So then we called, there's this particular matron that would treat us. She has her own hospital. So we bought drugs of at times of 50K, 100K, so at least they were still financially buoyant a little. So, and later, some people that later told us that it was spiritual. I was like, spiritual? It's not as if she offended anyone. It's not as if she has a car or anything. And it's close to 13 to 14 years now since we've lost our dad. And she's the only one taking care of the four of us. And due to our illness, I and my siblings had to stop school. So we had to look for one or two things to do to get money. And because of the money and the money for medicines and everything, feeding, because when it started, she could not go out anymore. So we had to resort into, you know, selling one or two things in the house. And even the place we were actually living before we moved in here, they actually chased us away due to we not paying the house rent. And we tried telling the man that, okay, that had it been my mom is feeling okay, that would be able to pay the house rent, but you know, landlords. So we had to leave and had to sort for money one way or the other to get this place, even though it was just little amounts we paid. And since then, we've been battling with it, buying different things for her. But because we didn't have enough money to do the operation, we had to like, okay, well, let's just do small, the little things we can that let us do it. But now, and most times in the night, she doesn't sleep. She doesn't sleep anymore at all. We are always doing vigil every night. And morning till evening, she might be okay, but once it is night, it is out of it. She was always crying in pain that even I myself, I won't be able to take it. So from there, we started selling one or two things that, okay, at least if we're having small money, at least we should be able to feed her and get some one or two drugs, pain relief and all that. But it has now gotten to the stage that it is no longer operable, like she can't operate it anymore. Because the breast is like, how will I put it, like it has rotten, like it's not, they can't operate it already. So, and it has affected her hand, so it's more or less like the hand is paralyzed too as well. So we just have to, you know, get cold water to like, okay, but to massage. She doesn't eat, she's now, and because of the thing, she's now lean. Like, it's every day. She's all like, she's getting lean every blessed day. And later, I went to the governor's office. I went to the governor's office to seek for assistance, at least. So, on getting there, the man I saw there told me, okay, oh, they don't want black and white paper, that I need to do it in some other form. I had to come back home because I had to borrow the money from someone. So I had to come back home again, look for another money to go there the next day again, which I know that money is something I can use to like feed the family that day. So I'm getting there the next day again. The person there said, that the letter is not lengthy enough. Ah, sir, you have to help me that me spending transport fare all the time, it is something. And he said, I have to write the party that she's doing. I was like, what's our own business with party? Like, I need to write the political party she's into, where she's doing it and all that. I just like out of, okay, I'll verge you, like, which means that if I don't write it there, and my mom is not, she's not a party woman, she's not into politics. Even I myself, I'm not into politics. So there's nothing I know about politics, to be honest. So I was like, even though if I even want to, those kind of things, I can't forge it. Like, I just packed them like, okay, no problem that. Anyhow, it is, which means that if she's not into politics, definitely they cannot help her. So I just had to like pack everything that, no worries that, thank you. So I'm getting on my toe, she started crying like, that is the auntie, she's into politics. I was like, oh, that she should just forget about it, that God will help. So and ever since then, we've been battling, even as at last night, to be honest, we didn't eat anything in this house. Even she has, aside from the food we ate in the morning, and even while cooking, our gas actually finished. So the morning to even fuel gas, there was nothing. I had to save the rice, like, let everybody eat it like that. Because ever since she's been, like, we've been spending a lot, like, too much. Now, to be honest, nothing is on us again. So, please, Nigerians, we are really begging. Like, we are really, really begging. I am not ready to lose my mom. Please, anything that they can use to help. Because even her breast is no longer operable. So we have to depend on chemotherapy and different things. And like she needs to be taking it every month. But with that, we don't even have enough money to eat in the house. How are we going to get money for chemotherapy? And there's no family. There's no one. She's the only one that is helping the family. We had to quit school, quit everything. And just to be with her. So please, we are begging. We really need help. We really need serious help. Please, anything is affordable. And my siblings, we are not ready to lose our mom. We are really not ready to lose our mom, because this is not the way it has been from the onset. Our family was once a happy family. This is not the way. Even though we resorted to this is somehow, but just please, anything Nigerians can use to help, we'll gladly appreciate, so as to fight for our life and save her.